Hard to believe, but in 4 weeks, America will make a choice about the future of America. Who will lead us, the U.S., in the next election? Who will the voters choose? Just last month, in our Care 11 Star Tribune NPR poll, an overwhelming majority, 79% of you, told us you're confident your vote is going to be counted accurately in that November election. So to reaffirm your confidence and to speak to the 21% of you that have doubts in our process, we want to explain how our state is making sure your vote counts. Here's John Croman.
I started doing recounts for state and federal offices 40 years ago this year.
40 years ago, this slightly younger version of Joe Manske was in that state office building across the street from the Capitol working for the Secretary of State's office. He would become Minnesota's preeminent expert on election operations, including a long stint as head of the Ramsey County Elections Office.
I unplugged our system from the network after the 2012 presidential election because even back then I was concerned about the possibility for hacking to occur.
Now it's standard. Vote tabulating machines are not connected to the internet while voting is taking place, and the machines are far more accurate than people when it comes to counting ballots.
What I used to see when I was out on the road counting literally hundreds of thousands of paper ballots is that inevitably I would find an average of 5 vote counting errors by the election judges for every 1,000 ballots.
Fast forward to the epic Coleman-Franken statewide recount of 2008 when optical scanning machines were in use.
The error rate there was 2 ballots for every 10,000 that we counted, an increase, an improvement of an order of magnitude, which is incredible. So going back to the hand counting is really not only going back in time, but it's going in a direction that's not good for us.
The paper ballot is, in fact, Minnesota's first defense against tampering with the equipment, according to Secretary of State Steve Simon.
If there's some allegation, for example, that a machine got it wrong, or worse, that someone got into the machine and that the machine was changing votes from candidate A to candidate B, you've got the record, you've got the receipts, you've got something you can touch and see and feel.
And by state law, every elections office has to run tests on the vote counting equipment before each primary and general election. And those tests are open to the public.
Anyone from the public can walk in off the street and watch as the election folks in that city or town or county basically try to trick the equipment. They will sometimes crease the ballot, or they will put stray marks on it, or they will underline the name instead of filling in the oval.
In the Care 11 NPR Star Tribune Minnesota poll, only 50% of respondents agreed that mail-in voting is protected from fraud. But mail-in ballots go through strict security protocol at the city and county level prior to election day.
Your ballot is sealed immediately upon you casting it, and it remains that way until it gets processed. The processing is done by 2 people who are of different political parties. So there is that built-in balance as a part of our system.
It's a rigged system, folks. It's a rigged system.
Former President Trump has raised the specter that non-citizens are voting, which is a felony, but it remains extremely rare in Minnesota with just 3 documented cases since 2008. Even immigrants who get driver's licenses must prove citizenship to vote.
A passport, a birth certificate, naturalization papers. The idea is to expressly limit anyone who's not a citizen of the United States even getting into the pile.
And the electronic poll books at the voting sites make it virtually impossible to vote in multiple locations the same day or vote in person and absentee.
I have been hearing exactly the same arguments being made for the last 40 years. There was no basis for them then, and I can assure you there is no basis for them now.
Now, some people might ask, if the machines are so accurate, why do they do the recounts by hand? Well, Manske said that helps verify the machine results, and he notes the recounts, they take their time. They're in a central location with attorneys, witnesses, campaigns watching the recount closely, so it's different than a hand count would be on election night, which, Jana, you know, they're going to try to do in Georgia this year.
Absolutely. Well, John, you and I were both here at Care 11 in 2008 with that Franken-Coleman election. And I don't even remember. I mean, months, I think you said it was, until we got the results. But we went through counting and watched them count every single day.
That's right. And they disputed over which ballots were valid and what somebody meant to do when they cross out one and mark in another. It's a big deal.
Oh, yeah. Okay, John Croman, thank you so much.